Hello everyone, it's Roseanne. Welcome if you're a new subscriber. I've seen quite a lot of views. I was so excited. I didn't see too many comments, but that's okay. I hope everyone is, please, if you can, hit the like button. That really helps the algorithm. Everybody knows this. I know everybody says the same thing, but it really does help the algorithm and gets my videos out there. We just completed the binding, which I added the pages to the centerpiece, and I'm using three pages, but they're folded in half. Well, that's the end. And then I went ahead and I sewed, and I love the way that it looks there, all shabby. So I sewed it three times back and forth, and then I went across, my ring's getting caught. I went across the bottom here and sewed three times, and then I went back up, and if I can get the right page here, this is the front, and then I went back up and I sewed three times, and now that's really fuzzy and really pretty. And I still may even add, you know me, I love the fuzzies. I still may go through and add like some type of a fiber or a lace. Like this was one that my friend Gail shared with me. It's actually a fabric, but I've been cutting it, you know, tearing it in between the sewing, and it creates a gorgeous little, like a trim. But we'll see. I could even use, now this is my, excuse me, this is my, a new lace in my store. I have an Etsy store, and I'll always have the link in the description if you're interested. But see, this would be pretty. Actually, it might be prettier this way, you know, to add there. That'll come later. But just so you have an understanding of, you know, if this looks messy, it's okay. We're gonna do a messy book. So nothing has to be perfect. Everything is gonna be, just have fun no matter what you do. Okay, so now, today I am going to embellish. This is a snippet that I had already started. If you haven't seen this video, it's a couple videos back. If I remember, I'll try to link it below the video that I did this. But as you see, everything is going to be just kind of wonky. Nothing's going to be perfect. We want everything to be very primitive. And I thought today I was maybe sew on this leave. And I learned a stitch. And before I got online, oh my gosh, I forgot her name. Sunbee. Kathleen. Kathleen Sunbee showed, I think she called it the, oh gosh, I am so bad with remembering things. It is a stitch. Did I write it down? It was just, I finally got my printer going. Oh my gosh, guys, I don't remember the name of the stitch. Yeah, I don't remember. Anyway, it's where I learned it from Kathleen. And let's hope I can remember how to do it. I saw the video quite a while ago, and I just love this stitch. So I saw this leaf in the fabric. I thought, oh my gosh, that's going to be perfect for doing this particular stitch. So I think she, if I remember correctly, I think she starts at the top of the leaf. See, we have this, the veins of the leaf here. So, she starts at the top. I think she goes, I can't remember. I think she goes here. See if I can get close so you guys can see. And then she's gonna come over here on the edge of the leaf there. Okay, there you go, like that. And I think what she's gonna do, and she just went a little bit. I think what she said, okay, so now you're on this side of the leaf. I think what she said is you want to go here, just like a needle's length down. So you go down. I hope I'm doing this right. But how did she... let me think a bit. Graze stitch. Okay, I'm sticking the needle from the back end up. Maybe that's how she did it. Yes, that's how she did it. Okay, so let me show you that again, guys, so that you understand. Okay, so you come up from the bottom. Right at the top, you come up from the bottom, you go over just about, I don't know, a quarter of an inch, and then you come up on this side, because this thread is going to be underneath, so you're going to come up on this side, and then what you do is this is the point of the needle, you get the back of the needle, and you stick it through, right? Stick it through that right there, pull the thread, and then what you're going to do is you're going to pull this way a little bit, like that. Is it going to focus? There we go, like that. Okay, so then your next stitch, you're going to come over here. Why is my darn phone blinking again? Doggone it. So you're going to come over here again. And then you're going to come out right next to that line. Along the edge of the leaf. Right? Along the edge of the leaf. So now you can see, right, like that, and then you see how you have like a little T-section here. You're going to get the back of your needle again, and oh, please focus. There we go. Is it focused, guys? You're going to stick your needle in there again. The back end. Now see, when you pull, you start making the veins of your leaf. So again, we're going to go here, down this way, and up, you know, up over here. So we're going to come up right over here, and just a little tiny bit from that thread. So again, you're going to come up, and if this fabric was sturdier. It'd be a lot easier. So you're gonna pull that there. Okay, and then see, you have this thread here. And you have this thread here. Right? So hard to show that. Right? You have this thread and this thread. So you're gonna, again, the back of the needle. Oh my gosh, it's so hard to do this on camera. So just follow this, you know, this last thread here and that last thread, and you're gonna stick your needle here and here and pull it through. And you see, if I can hold it, the more you pull it this way, you can keep your line in the vein, on the leaf vein. So let me pull it so you can see what I'm talking about. Please focus. There it is. Okay, so see, naturally, you want to go down here, come up here, and then stick the back end of the needle through. Okay, so now I think I've said it enough times. And you can always slow down the video. So go here, down. Right, down. Come up. I hope I'm doing it the right way. Or I'll be showing you the wrong way. Okay. Oh gosh, I can't hold on to anything. Okay, so then you have this thread here and this thread here. You're gonna go, right? You're gonna go here and here with the back end of the needle. And then pull. Pull down. And you're going to start to see your leaf. Okay. So down here. I'm going to take it here. And then back up over here somewhere. Right there. Now, when you look at your back, I'll show you right now, okay, you're going to have a lot of thread this way in the back when you do this. So you're going to go through a lot of thread. Okay, so you use the back of the needle and you go here and here. And then just pull it down. Just pull it down, just like that. Isn't that fun? And look at how cool that stitch looks. Okay, so down. Down and then up. And then back of the needle through here and through that stitch. And then pull down. See, and you can pull that. It's getting a little off from the vein on the leaf. Okay, so let's do it again. Down here, I'll put the name of the stitch in the description, as I've got to go to her video and figure out what the name is. Okay, so there's that. And then up through here. And actually, I'm going to go down a little bit. Yep, come up right there. And then through here and through here. And pull that stitch down. And I'm going to add a thread here. So pull that stitch down. Like that. Isn't that cool? Okay, so down. And come up over here. Oh, I want to go further down. Right there. Okay. And then here and here. I just want to pull that down. Now I'm getting short on thread. So I might be able to do one more. There's that. And then one right here. Now we have the leaf cut off, so it's going to look funny, right? Because the picture of the leaf should go like here, but it's okay. We'll put something right there to conceal that. Okay, so here. Now I just want to go here and here. And I'm sorry, so much movement, guys. Just like that. And now what I'm going to do is, since I have a small thread, I don't remember how she tied it off. I'm going to go directly down right there in the center, because I want to hold that line right there. So I don't know if she did that, but I'm going to do that. So see, it holds that line right there. And then I'm just going to tie off in the back. Just a knot here. And my string is so short. See, I can't get the needle. Oh, maybe I can. Yeah, but if you can't, just use the back of your needle. That way you can pull the thread through and tie your knot. Okay, so let's see how my time is. Okay. So let's see if I can hold it steady. There we go. Can you see that? Isn't that neat? That's so cool. And then I'm going to go around and just do like a daisy or stem stitch around the end or the edge. But let's finish this. Let's see if my camera will allow me to finish this. Okay. So, what do I want to do? Okay, I think I want to come up here. No. I want to come up in the middle here. Yeah, I'm going to come up in the middle. I'm just kind of figuring this out on my own here. Okay, yeah. I'm going to move this thread down, and I'm going to come up on the other side of that thread. Because that's going to be my anchor, I think. Well, I don't want to get the thread there. I don't know if you can see that. Oh, little camera. What is going on here? No, that ain't gonna work. I tried to turn the light on. There we go. So see, it's right. I pushed this over and came up. Because I want to anchor this thread this way. Okay, so now I can go down. Is it going down? Oh, see. Now we're going to go backwards. No, I'm going to go this way. I'm going to go down this way. I only watched her video once. I should have paid more attention. And up. Okay, there we go. Down this way and up. Right? And then again, we'll just go back of the needle through here and through here. And pull that down. Yes, okay, we got it now. Okay, so then down here. Oh, I better make sure that fabric is where it needs to be. Okay, down. Yeah, I had to catch this fabric in the back. So down. I'm gonna pull that this way. And then up over here. Right, up over here. And then again, back of the needle. And pull that down. Okay, then down. And I think if you use all six of the threads, let me go right there. This will be a really big statement because the threads will be thicker. Pull this through. Okay, back of the needle. Go through here and that one. Pull down, and now I'm just gonna go right at that end there, down, there. Is it gonna focus? There we go. Look at that. Isn't that cool? All right. Now I want to do, I think I'm going to do the stem stitch. So just continue on. I'm going to go back down here and then come up. And then I'm just going to go on the other side of this line. Down. And then come up. Oh gosh, this thread is, or this fabric, this older fabric is kind of tough to go through. Okay, so I'm going to go right before here and then come up a little bit over that line. So down here, and then up. Maybe right there. Gosh. Okay. And down and up. And then down, and I'm pushing this thread over a little bit and trying to come up on, see the points of the leaf. I'm trying to come up on those points or right beside it somehow. We're gonna have to tack this down because it keeps getting in the way. Okay, so then push this aside. Just come up right there. Let's see. Now, when you're doing this, if you pull too tight, your leaf is gonna, you know, make sure you have these just flat. You're not pulling them too tight, because then your leaf will be like this if you pull too tight. Let me go there. I don't know how this is going to turn out, but we'll see. My first time doing this, so I was just so excited to try it. And you probably go to her channel and see that it's completely different. Probably should go here. I'm trying to follow the line of the leaf, but I'm not doing a really good job at doing that. But it's okay. This is not a perfect book. It's supposed to be fun. Okay, right there. I hope you guys can see. I may need to I'll try to get right there on the corner. I wonder if I can zoom. I don't know. But I think what I'll do, ladies, is I'm going to stop here. I'm going to go right there at the end. I'll finish the other side. And then on my next video, we'll go to the next step. There. So It's because it's so hard for me to show. Okay, now I'm just going to go down and tie off. Okay, guys. So that's what it's looking like so far. Isn't that cool? Now, if you ladies would like to try this, really, really simple way to do it is you just get a piece of green fabric. Okay, get a piece of green fabric. Let me see if I can. Okay, like this. I've shown many times how to do a leaf. Really simple. Let's just cut this here. And I think I have another one. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know where it is right now. But all you need to do is you have a rectangle, right? So you just need to start at this corner and go up, right? You see that? And then turn it upside down. Start at this corner and go about halfway up. Okay, and you got yourself a leaf. Then you could do this on this and sew it on your fabric as you're doing it, if you wanted to do that. Okay? Anyway, really simple way to make a leaf. Yeah, I think that's all. Thank you so much, ladies. Please give me the thumbs up. It really helps the algorithm. I would love to hear from you. See if you like what you're seeing so far. And if you're doing your own book, leave me a comment and tell me, and I will go visit your channel too. Okay, bye everyone. God bless. And I'm going to run over and see Sonia's video because I think she is, playing along, not following along. You don't need to follow along. You can make your own book and maybe do some of the stitches that I show that you like or do your own stitches. It's perfectly fine. This is your book. Do it as you want to do it. So, yeah. Okay. Bye, everyone. God bless. Thank you so much for spending time with me. Welcome to all my new subbies, and I will see you all very soon. Bye. God bless.